Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Melissa and I'm always here on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Friday, and every other Sunday. I talk about true crime, I talk about missing children, and I also talk about important topics. Today I have a new case to talk about, and today we're going to be talking about innocence. It's somebody that just end up dying and they end up being proved innocent even after they already have passed. So they were guilty, but come to find out they're innocent. So this one is really different because I do not have a lot of background on the persons. It's just a little, I found a short article, but then I found another one that explains everything about the case, but it really doesn't explain a lot about the background. It just explains how still to this day the justice system is still putting people on death row that did not commit a crime. So that's what are we going to be talking about. So if you are interested in any of that, go ahead and subscribe and also hit that bell so you can be notified every time I upload a new video. With that being said, I like starting my YouTube videos with a poem of the day. So let's go ahead and start with that. So today I am the girl who is always there for people when they need a friend. I'm also the girl who face many issues alone but will still do anything to see someone else smile. So that it is. So today we're going to be talking about, I just got home, and so we're gonna be talking about Larry Griffin. Was he innocent or was he guilty? Let's find out together. So if Larry, give me one second guys. Okay, so if Larry Griffin were being tried today for the murder of Quinn Mose, he would almost certainly be acquitted. The evidence is overwhelming that he did not kill Mr. Mose. But Mr. Griffin is not being tried today. He has already been executed for the murder. While significant, this development is not that much of a surprise to those who understand that human beings are fallible and that much of the criminal justice system in the United States is crapshot. Whether it's this case or some other, it's inevitable that we will learn of someone who has been executed for a crime that he or she did not commit. Judges or juries are not less prone to mistakes in the politicians, reports, doctors, engineers, or center fielders, which is why the death penalty should be abolished. Larry Griffin case is probably not the best one for advancing this argument, but it is the case at hand. He was not just a soil citizen. While it seemed clear that he did not commit the crime for which he was executed, the killing of Mr. Mose, he did plead guilty to killing someone else. Mr. Griffin's character of Lake of Same does not make the principle at stake any less vital. This was recognized by Jennifer Joyce, the circuit attorney in San Luis where Mr. Moses was murdered back in the 1980s. Mr. Joyce has taken the extraordinary step officially reopening a murder investigation after the defendant was executed. Quinn Moses was 19 years old and a local well-known drug dealer when he was shot 13 times in a drive-by attack on a nutritious block in St. Louis known as the Strolled. A bartender, Wallace and Corners, were also shot but not seriously wounded. Mr. Corners, who knew Larry, saw the man who drove up and opened fire. He said Mr. Griffin was not one of them, but he was never called either by the prosecution or the defense to testify at Mr. Griffin's trial. The key testimony was given by Robert, a professional criminal who said he had witnessed the murder and defined Mr. Griffin as one of the shooters. Mr. Robert was in the Federal Witness Protection Program at the time. He had a number of felony charges pending and was an admitted user of heroin and speed. A Missouri Supreme Court justice said Mr. Robert, the only witness to the murder, has seriously flawed background, and his ability to observe and define the gunman was also subject to question. There was no physical evidence against Mr. Griffin, and no one else at the trial placed him at the scene of the attack. But he was convicted nonetheless and executed by lethal injection on June 21st of 1995. Mr. Robert was formally released from custody on the day that Mr. Griffin was convicted. One of the reasons we have not had a tentative sample of the execution of an innocent person is that the official investigation ceased once death penalty had been carried out. In this case, an extremely unusual private investigation was conducted after Mr. Griffin's death. It was sponsored by the NAACP Legal Defense Educational Fund and led by Samuel Cross, a professor at the University of Michigan Law School. That investigation has pretty much demolished Mr. Robert's account of what occurred and promote to Ms. Johnson to reopen the case. Mr. Corners, the wound bystander, says flatly that Mr. Robert, who died last year, was not at the scene when the attack took place. And a St. Louis police officer who supported Mr. Robert's account at the trial now says that Mr. Robert told him, "I didn't see nothing." This officer said he can't explain why he supported Mr. Robert's falsely testimony at the trial. Professor Cross, who had received an extensive promoting law firms, has given prosecutors the names of three men he believes committed the murder and the evidence that points to their guilt. Ms. Joyce, who is reopening the case, was not in the circuit attorney office when Mr. Griffin was prosecuted. She told me in a telephone conversation yesterday, "I just want to see the truth." The investigation will be throughout, she said, adding, "I want to take an independent look at it and make mistakes were made, do what I can to rectify them, and recognize that there may not be much I could do." And that is the case of Larry. I know this case was too short, but like I said, I couldn't find anything. But this is another example, and I have so many other case people that I have been accused of crimes that did not commit and end up dying because police did not, or detectives did not want to do their jobs. And it is sad to know that it's still, to this day, it's still happening, and we need to change it. And I feel like this change is talking about these type of cases, about these victims that lost their lives for no reason when they were innocent. Yes, like they say, Larry did confess to another murder. He probably would have been in prison because of the other murder, but it probably would have been life and not the death penalty. But he died for committing a murder that he did not commit. And so it's like, and it sucks that some people lose their lives for something that, because detectives don't want to do their job the right way. But yeah, that is the story of him. I will be back on Friday, and I will be with the new missing child's case, so y'all look out for that. And I also will be on Sunday. I think it's this Sunday that I was supposed to upload, and I didn't, so I may be up this Sunday. If not, I will upload Saturday. I don't know. But you'll see me Friday for sure.